Ladies and gentlemen, we are ready for the main event of the evening. Would somebody somewhere please make some noise? This bout is scheduled for 8 3-minute rounds. Once again, this bout is scheduled for 8 3-minute rounds of professional heavyweight boxing. It is sponsored by Hydrate Zero. Now making his way to the blue corner, here is Joseph Parker!
Well, this is what it's all about. Joseph turned professional after a stunning amateur career last July, stopping Dean Grumman's way. Knocked out his next three opponents, decided it was time to go to the States with the Kevin Barry to train him in Las Vegas, Nevada, my hometown. Of course, Kevin known for world champions Marcelino Maceo, Babut Shumanov, and getting David Tua all the way to a world championship fight. He's been working on learning to throw his jab and keep his opponent outside and developing strength for even more power. Kevin very pleased with his last fight where he won a unanimous decision over Bryce Rattani Coe in Los Angeles. Here he comes, a wonderful, wonderful guy from a wonderful family. Met his mother and dad the last fight out here. And I'm really excited, Mike Gangope, to find out if he really and truly has improved since I saw him last time.
Well, that's the key, and the other thing I think we've got to look out for is he going to get caught in between styles, trying to act on new things, trying to implement a new game plan, which is the reason Kevin Barry wanted him to have the fight in the States against Bryce Rattani Coe, just so he could work on that, because getting caught in between styles can cause a pause, which you don't want to have against a guy like Botha.
Now, this is a big stage for this guy, and all the guys watching at the Stockhill Motor Club, they couldn't get in because Duco did such a great job selling this event out, but they're enjoying it over there. So, guys, I hope you enjoy seeing the pride of South Auckland, New Zealand. 5-0, 4 knockouts. Beautiful, beautiful guy, and I'm hoping that he is the future of New Zealand boxing. And I know that wherever you're watching around this country, you're hoping the same thing. And all you folks that are watching in South Africa, we might be seeing the last fight for Francois Botha, who's had a dramatic career, and certainly will test this young man tonight. 21-year-old Joseph Parker.
He certainly looks relaxed, Colonel.
Very relaxed. One thing I did notice about him, he's a lot bigger in his shoulders than when I saw him in his last fight here in Auckland. And that's the work that Kevin's given him while he's maintained not having the big bulk in his biceps, which is the perfect build for a fighter, especially this guy. Joseph Parker is going to have to grow into his body. He's fighting at about 232 pounds, and he's going to go up and probably fight at 250 by the time he's 6 or 7 years older, and that's the size of the big heavyweights today.
Yeah, well, certainly they say that the heavyweights don't really hit their physical prime till the late 20s.
Francois Botha, an absolutely wonderful gentleman. 360 professional rounds of boxing to the 13 for Parker. Veteran, 10 world title fights. He did win the IBF World Championship in 1995 when he beat Axel Schultz in Stuttgart, Germany. I had the pleasure of calling that fight. He was later stripped of that title. Been fighting professionally since 1990. Won his first 36 professional fights. In his next 21 fights, he lost 5 times, but to Mike Tyson, Lennox Lewis, Vladimir Klitschko, Evander Holyfield, Michael Moore, all world champions. He lost his last 4 fights, but he's gone the distance all the way, and everybody who follows boxing knows how he was robbed in the Sonny Bill Williams fight when they changed the fight suddenly from 12 rounds to 10 rounds when he was coming on to try to knock him out in the late rounds of the fight. This one is 8 rounds, and Mike, we can assure everybody it will be 8 rounds.
Well, certainly it's well established, and it'll be interesting to see the change in tactics from Botha. Last time the plan was to take him into deep water and start to come on in rounds 9, 10, 11, and 12. Of course, 11 and 12 never happened, but an 8 round round fight, a lot less to work with. So I expect to see Botha go to work a lot earlier.
This sturdy old pro has had a marvelous professional career, 48-9-2. He knows every trick in the trade. And as nice as this guy is inside the ring, you can look for headbutts, low blows, trying to spin his opponent. He'll try to make it a rough-looking fight. He'll try to grab. He'll try to hit on breaks. He'll do all those things that sturdy old pros do to try to get one more big payday. This guy's no fool either. He owns three businesses in his native South Africa, coal exporting business. Very, very nice guy. Totally relaxed and has done a marvelous job helping Duco Events promote this fight.
You've got to say at this stage, there is nothing that this stage presents that will faze Francois Botha.
I've got mixed emotions in calling this fight because I love young Joseph Parker. He's been in my hometown training in Las Vegas, and I've known Francois Botha and called all of his fights since he was Joseph Parker's age of 21 when he first came to the States.
Well, he's been a stalwart game for such a long time. Has he got one more upset left in those arms?
This fight is scheduled for 8 3-minute rounds of professional heavyweight boxing. It is brought to you by Hydrate Zero, on the edge of performance and recovery. Now, fighting out of the blue corner, he enters the ring wearing black trunks. He's 21 years old and stands at 1.94 meters. He weighed in at 102.9 kgs. He hails from South Auckland, New Zealand. He has 5 professional fights with 5 wins, with 4 big wins coming by way of KO. Introducing Joseph Parker!
You may have seen that guy in the suit hug him. That's Rich Moriarty, who is a big sponsored investment banker from Las Vegas.
And his opponent fighting out of the red corner. Enters the ring wearing black trunks. He is 44 years old, stands at 1.88 meters tall, weighted at 116.5 kgs. He hails from Durban, South Africa. He has 60 professional fights with 48 wins, 9 losses, and 3 draws, with 29 wins coming by way of KO. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the White Buffalo, Francois Botha!
Brad Vocabi,
your international
will
referee in charge,
referee this fight. As you take a look at the tail of the tape, big differences, of course, the weight. Joseph Parker is 30 pounds lighter, and he's 23 years younger. He's also taller, and the reach is about the same. So the final instructions are being given. General punch scoring system, no standing 8 count.
Yeah,
no 3 knockdown
we gave you some
rule.
Very strict instructions in the rules meeting yesterday. I repeated those round, instructions in the dressing room prior.
That's
you understand
Brad
that?
Kelly speaking.
You must punch with the knuckle part of the glove to the scoring part of the body. There is a 3 knockdown rule. You cannot be saved by the bell in any round. There is no standing 8 count. Do you understand that? Punch with the knuckle part of the glove. Do not punch on the back of the head. Nothing in the kidney and nothing below the belt. If your opponent's on the ground, don't hit him while he's there. It is a foul. I will penalise you. Protect yourself at all time. Touch gloves, go back to your corner and wait for the bell.
Let's go.
No friendly look by Franz that time. By the way, Brad Vocali just informed us that there is no standing in count, but there is a 3 knockdown rule, so they aren't using the unified rules of boxing. Kevin Barry, a little kiss on the cheek for encouragement. There's the White Buffalo, Francois Botha, the pride of South Africa. And again, we welcome, on behalf of Hydrate Zero and Duco Events, everybody watching in South Africa tonight. Here we go.
And we're underway. Let's see whether Parker can make that jab work.
You're watching internationally. Parker, of course, the younger-looking guy. Parker in the front of his trunks, black and gold. The White Buffalo, the guy with the white hair and the solid black trunks.
Botha's already getting onto range with his jab. Takes a little left hook for his trouble.
Trying to, but so far he hasn't been able to grab him. A lot of more power I'm seeing from Joseph here in the early going. Notice that Joseph is keeping him at length. This is his first solid right hand that he's thrown. So this is a surprise that he's able to dictate this with a wily old vet, the White Buffalo.
And you saw the example of that where Botha missed by a good 6 inches with that right hand. Parker able to maintain that range. Kevin Barry was talking about trying to get him to leverage off his legs, use the huge power in his legs to leverage the shots.
And he's got that, and he just blasted Botha right below his heart in the rib cage. And look at this, Joseph hangs on in the inside. France continues to throw. This is when he could be dangerous, as you look at the ref cam.
Yeah, just cautious of Botha just hitting on the break there. Brad Vicali will have to do a lot of work.
Yeah, he's not going to stop this wily old vet from hitting
on the
break.
What's the back of the head, France? What's the back of the head? Break! Break!
He said one important thing from Brad, a very experienced referee. Watch the back of the head. Nice stiff jab.
Come on,
now,
work,
the
out
hand
of
speed
work out of it.
Of Joseph Park, I'm going to point out to you, because he just clipped him as Botha was coming in, and that's great hand speed.
Just like to see him fake a little bit more, because Botha's still trying to land that right hand over the top. And he's come close a couple of times. That's his trademark punch. Sneaky right hand over the top of a jab.
Different though, Mike, in the last time I saw him, young Park is not rushing the fight. Just glanced him across the chin with that right hand. Look at the hand speed for this heavyweight.
And patience too, just finding his range there. Botha trying to sucker him in.
Good luck, Joseph.
Caught him with the left
hook. Good luck, Joseph.
Tell you, Joseph is a much better fighter. And I can tell you immediately from watching him in this fight than what I saw of him before. I had a chance to see him in training in Las Vegas, but this is really extraordinary now. This is good stuff.
Really using his range well there, snapping out that jab. Nice punch selection going to the body. Botha didn't like it.
Notice, folks, the way he pulls back and gets out of there at an angle, and then he ties Botha up when he comes in.
Also, in the first of his five fights, he wouldn't have tied up. He would have been trying to go to work an in-fight.
But you notice he's not throwing as many punches, but in the professional ranks, you want to land a shot. Fran's got a light left hand, loaded up the wild right hand, windmill over the ears of young Joseph Parker.
Brad Vicali on that early. But that's his Sunday punch, Francois Botha.
And with Joseph's head moving up and down, nice first round for Joseph. This is a better fighter. This is Francois Botha's wife watching. And his daughter, by the way.
You're one of the few in the crowd favoring Botha. And he got clipped early on with that left hook. But the work there from Parker, just finding his range, ghosting back out of range, not allowing Botha to get that right hand. Got to trick him into an inside fight, which is where Botha can apply all his dirty tricks.
Boy, I'm so impressed. I wish Kevin would pull those hands down. Kevin's such an intense guy himself, you know. He won the silver medal.
Watch him when he's jumping. He's jumping in with that right hand. Hey, I want to see that. I want to see that. That left hand up a little higher.
Tells him to keep the left hand up a little bit higher. Is Frans Botha. This is round number two. This is scheduled for eight rounds.
I've warned him. Don't worry. Let's go. Fight.
All right, here we go. Let's see if Joseph can keep him at bay as he did. Fighting outside. This is perfect so far for Joseph Parker. He did everything but land the big right hand to drop him, and nobody's really expecting that. Joseph very quick on his feet as well when France faints and yells. He got hit with a decent right hand, not a solid right hand, but it did spin the head of Joseph. So that's an indication a bit, Mike, that he can take a little bit of a shot.
Yeah, it's also an indication that he just needs to be cautious. You can't afford to give a guy an even break. Botha just mouthing off, trying to really, yeah, little forearm there. He was tempted to throw a slap around the back of the head just to disconcert Parker.
And Brad's been right on top of that. The referee, he's one of the best in the world. WBC, IBF, WBA.
Range there from Parker, just snuck into range
on,
a little bit too close without throwing,
without
buying his way in with the jab.
This is what Botha wants to do now, Mikey. He wants to make it this a sloppy fight now and drag this guy to maybe the seventh or eighth round and then try to pick up the pace a little bit in an area that Joseph's never been. But Joseph's not going to have any part of it. Franz laughs at him, but that's only to try to upset this kid. Joseph is too cool. Nice snapping jab. Love that snapping jab. Not throwing it as often, but you don't need to do that as a heavyweight as often. Nice uppercut in the inside by Joseph. He's not going to be had by this guy in the inside.
Brad Vicali calling for him to punch out. That's a nice little hockey right hand there, Joseph Parker, as he went under Botha's right hand. signs that he's seeing it.
Boy, this is a completely different professional fighter. Fighting like a professional heavyweight now. And this is very good. Remember, this is only a sixth pro fight.
Right.
I mean, when I call all of George Foreman's first professional fights, like 1 through 20, he didn't fight anybody of the caliber of Frans Botha.
Don't hold, Judge.
Despite the fact that Frans is 44.
Right.
This guy is still dangerous. Foreman, even, as good as he was, never took that chance in the first 20 fights he had.
Well, they asked me early on, just previewing.
Oh, the right hand! Almost shot Francois! Caught him again! Right on top of the nose! Bangs ahead! Frans not able to hang on! Johnson is going to try to finish it! It's all over! It's all over! How about that? Joseph Parker knocks out Francois Botha with a combination of punches, a big right hand, and then about five shots in a row. That is absolutely brilliant.
And any questions about the power of Joseph Parker or the coming of age of Joseph Parker, you just saw it. He stuck to the game plan. He waited for his opportunity, and he drew Francois Botha. And you've got to remember, Botha has been in his world-class fights. It's four out of his last five, and he did not get dropped. He went into the 11th or 12th round in all of them.
You know, you always give the athlete the credit because he eventually had to do it. But I'm telling you, not because Kevin Barry is a mate of mine, but he has done a sensational job in what I've seen in the progression from this fight to the fight that he had in Los Angeles and to this fight with this wily old vet. I mean, when it was time to load up the power, he got inside, and he fought like a heavyweight tonight, Mike.
Absolutely. Kevin Barry talked earlier on this week about, said there was that overhand right, and we saw signs of it, and that was the beginning of the end for Botha.
But I love this, Mike, because now he has the killer instinct. You see this?
Well, exactly. He was selective in his punches, but he finished him. He smelled blood, and he put the old dog away. And that was a killer punch. That was a devastating shot from a kid who is only going to get stronger and more powerful.
Frans just couldn't defend himself in the end. Brad was coming in, but there's another solid right. After he saw all of this stuff from the ref cam, and he had to stop the fight. That's exactly what he was watching. This is what the ref saw. One heavy big blow there. Big right hand shot. Another right hand. Left rights, and that's it. And Frans Botha is knocked out.
Well, sickening stuff to watch, but Francois Botha, perhaps the close of his career, and certainly the coming of age for Joseph Parker.
We'll be back with more, and we'll get the final rendition of exactly what the particulars are. You stick with us on Sky TV. So they're back, and I think our ring announcer, Lieutenant Dan Hennessy, is ready with the decision. So, Dan, take it away.
All right, fighters to the center ring, please.
One piece of advice. Speed brings power. You've shown it.
Thank you.
Right? Very good, very good.
Fighters to the center ring, please.
The center ring, yeah, accolade.
Ladies and gentlemen, 2 minutes and 32 seconds into the second round, your winner by TKO and still undefeated, fighting out of the blue corner, Joseph Parker!
A terrific win for Joseph Parker. That's his dad in the ring with him. And now they're great mates after that. I'm just so impressed with this guy, Joseph Parker. Wonderful fight for him. And I tell you, all you Kiwis can be proud of this guy. Very proud of him. Let's go up as we take a look at this again. Go ahead, Mike.
Well, he used the jab. He maintained range. He stuck to the game plan, and that was really important. Botha tried to land the sneaky right handy. tried to hear of his sneaky shots. As much as Botha talked, he leaned back on the ropes and that chin was exposed. And there it was, the right hand on the temple. And Botha smelled blood and put his man away. He didn't let him off the hook, didn't let him regain his senses. And it was all over. Perhaps one punch too many from Brad McCarley. Francois Botha was legless.
That's a brilliant victory. I hope that you watching here around New Zealand can appreciate just what he has done such a great job here. And only his sixth professional fight. He's got five knockouts in his six professional fights. Well, I see that our man is in there. And let's go to Stephen McIver. Stephen, take it away.
Well, Francois, I suppose when people want to make a statement, young Joseph made a little bit of a statement tonight.
Shit, yeah, man, he caught me by my surprise. I never thought maybe Joseph could do this, but anyway, he went in and did it. I mean, take my hat off to him.
Fast hands.
Fast hands, you know, baby Joseph is just gonna go. I call him baby Joseph, but I mean, he's not baby Joseph anymore. He's a big man. And if the guys take care of him, he can go and break some bones, break some chins.
You know what it's like to fight the best in the world. Has this kid got the talent?
Oh, definitely so. I mean, he's got Kevin Barry with him. He's got a good management team. So if I take care of him and do the right thing with him, he's going to go a long way.
Are we going to see you back?
Yeah, Buffalo, come back and I...